The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Monday, 9:43 a.m., and the weather had turned unseasonably chilly in the Big Apple. The muggers in Central Park were wearing mittens. The roller skaters on Broadway were thinking of changing to hockey skates. And hot tomato soup was being billed as gazpacho at the fashionable bistros along 3rd Avenue. We were working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Frankly. The captain is Joe Greco. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician.
Hi, Georgie Porgy. How's tricks?
Hello, Katie Waity. Things are fine. Thanks for the inquiry.
I had a great weekend, George.
Really happy for you, Kate. Do you know how many miles of subway track there are in New York?
Ask me why my weekend was so great, George.
354 kilometers. That's almost 220 miles. Why was it so great?
What are you reading?
It's a guidebook about New York City. The Statue of Liberty is 151 feet high.
Because I spent it with an old college friend.
How old?
Eve Adams.
Uh-huh.
You aren't listening to me, George.
I am, too. Eve Adams is old.
Eve Adams and I went to college together, and she's just come into town in a Broadway show.
Really? What show?
It's a revival of Anything Went.
That old chestnut?
Uh-huh. She's got the second lead. Actually, we both acted in college for a while.
Then you went into mathematics and she stayed in showbiz?
Uh-huh.
How anyone could choose showbiz over mathematics is beyond me. I guess it takes all kinds.
Eve and I picked up as though we'd seen each other yesterday.
I thought you said you did see each other yesterday.
You know what I mean. We stayed up too late just gabbing the way we used to do in school. It was terrific.
Sounds it.
She's coming by this morning. Going to give me a couple of Annie Oakleys.
She's giving you two cowgirls?
Annie Oakley is slang for a free ticket. I thought a theater buff like you would know that.
I do know that, Kate. So she's in Anything Went, is she? Must be the role of Doodah Dora, the rebellious postmistress on the island.
That's right. She's also the understudy for the star. Do you know the show?
Sure. It's a classic from the 50s. It was a big hit for Lauren Bacchanal. She played the leading lady, Miss Fig.
Miss Bacchanal is playing the lead again.
Really? She's getting a little long in the tooth for that part. You know, Kate, a little too old. I don't see how she'd be able to pull off the underwater tap dancing number or that aria she sings to the good-natured owl.
Well, she's doing it anyway. You want to see the show tonight, George?
I'd love to, Kate.
I'm sorry, there's not an extra ticket for Martha.
That's okay. Tonight's her night at school.
She's taking more classes.
Sure. Martha doesn't let the grass grow around her shoes.
What's she studying?
Toxicology. What time's the curtain?
8 o'clock sharp. Don't be late. Eve.
Hi, Catherine.
Catherine?
Eve, this is my partner, George.
Frankly, Mathnet.
Oh, nice to meet you, George. Catherine's told me so much about you.
Catherine?
Catherine.
Catherine Muriel Monday.
Snodfest College, class of...
Never mind the year.
You darling.
Here are the tickets. I've got a dash.
Wait, how's the show going?
Oh, we've had pretty good luck out of town, thanks.
Where'd you preview?
Philly.
Good houses?
75% paid. The rest papers.
What are you guys talking about?
What?
Good houses, out of town, papered?
Before you bring the show to New York, you usually open it out of town, Philadelphia or Boston or someplace like that.
Why?
To work the bugs out, and it's cheaper out of town. Broadway musicals are very expensive.
Oh, they sure are. This show is capitalized at $4 million.
$4 million?
Uh-huh.
Who invests money like that?
Angels.
Angels?
Investors in Broadway shows are called angels because their money is thought of as money from heaven.
Actually, with this show, Ms. Bacchanal put up half. So, all they had to raise was $2 million. Of course, we haven't seen any of it.
You haven't been paid?
The cast and crew agreed to wait for our money, so Ms. Bacchanal could use it for the production.
Eve, how is Lauren Bacchanal to work with?
She's a real pro, for sure. She knows what she wants, and she gets it. I'm sure she's played this role thousands of times. So she knows just how she wants everything done.
That bad, eh?
No. I didn't mean that. She's just... well...
her nickname is the Iron Stage Mother.
I see. Eve, if she put up half the money, does that mean she makes half the profits?
No, she gets 75 points.
Really?
What's that mean?
Points are what Broadway people call percentages.
So each point is 1%.
She gets 75% of the profits.
And the investors make the other 25%?
No, they end up with 15 points. The writer of the show gets 4 points. The composer gets 2 points. The lyricist gets 2 points.
Well, that's 8 points. So that leaves 17% for the investors, not 15%.
The director of the show also gets 2 points. That leaves 15% for the investors.
$2 million for only 15% of a show. Isn't that a risky investment?
I've done a lot of backers auditions, so I know how it works. I'll show you. The theater seats 1,000. Let's assume it's a hit, and we sell out.
What's the average ticket price, Eve?
Approximately $40. That means if we sell out the performance, we take in $40,000.
Just for one performance?
We give 8 performances each week. That's a possibility of $320,000. Now that's gross, but the nut.
That means costs. Paying the actors, musicians, stagehands, renting the theater.
Uh-huh.
The nut is 60%.
Costs are $192,000. That leaves $128,000 a week profit.
That's more than I make.
You know how much you'd make if you sold out for a year? 52 weeks, $320,000 a week. $16,640,000.
Wow. Wouldn't take that long to make your $2 million back.
That's gross, though.
Right. Deduct the nut. The profit would be $6,656,000 a year. 15% of that, it's almost $1 million for the investors.
Any investment is a little risky, but the payback is rather nice if you have a hit on your hands. I'd love to talk more, but I...
you have to dash?
See you after the opening. Show!
Break a leg.
Knock him dead, kid.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy, what?
Oh, boy, it's gonna be fun. Catherine. get him wearing the darn thing.
Seen this when the leading lady was alive.
Loved it, George.
It was a blast from the past. Let's go to Sardi's.
And wait for the reviews.
I had never been to a Broadway opening night party, and I must admit, I was somewhat in awe. All the stars and ex-stars and would-be stars were there. All the newspaper columnists and television reviewers, the directors and choreographers. There was even a writer. It was a world unto itself. The festivities were fraught with tension as we waited for the reviews of the show. If the notices were good, in other words, if the reviewers liked the show, it could run for a long time and make money. If they were bad, well, they could lose a fortune. We waited for the reviews and waited and waited.
Miss Bacchanal, I'm George Frankly, Mathnet.
I'm so sorry.
Just like to say, I enjoyed your performance.
Thank you. And now I know you have to leave.
Oh, no. Martha's got a class.
I just assumed you had to have your clothes back by midnight. Darling!
What?
Is she as charming as we thought?
Charminger.
Having a good time?
Marvelous, darling. Simply marvelous.
I knew you would. I simply knew.
What street? What street? For God's sake, the reviews are in. Whoopee time in the old corral, huh?
Ooh, Clive loved it in the Post.
Frank liked it a lot in the Times.
Mustafa quelled in the Voice.
I wonder what the TV folks are saying.
I'm Rex Reed, just back from yet another Broadway opening, and I'm here to tell you anything went, a show which should have gone years ago hasn't, and it shouldn't. Despite aging star Lauren Bacchanal, that's right, despite Lauren Bacchanal, this show could make it on the Great White Way. It has verve, it has panache, it has Eve Adams, and she is wonderful. She does a tuneful, tearful, terrific turn as Doodah Dora, and she may be the star Broadway has been looking for lo, these many dreary seasons. She's a winner. The This is Rex Reed saying, move over, Lauren Bacchanal, as in move over and out.
Eve, this is wonderful.
Oh, thanks, Catherine. I'm thrilled. Oh, I've got to say, after all these years, maybe it will pay off.
Well, if it doesn't, there's always mathematics.
That's right, George.
Miss Bacchanal, the show's going to make it.
Maybe yes, maybe no.
Oh, he loved you. You know how he's always kidding big stars.
Would you please remove yourselves from our path?
Miss Bacchanal, I wonder if I might trouble you for an autograph. It's for my mom. She used to take me to all your shows when I was a little boy.
I should treat that remark with the contempt it so richly deserves.
You have a nasty streak in you, George, frankly.
Does it show?
It was Tuesday, 4:43 p.m., and we were still basking in the glory of Eve Adams' soon-to-be stardom. It makes a person happy to see a friend succeed. I was happy, or at least I was happy until George said...
There she is now, Eve. Kate, it's Eve.
Something wrong?
I don't know.
Hi, Eve, it's Kate. Catherine. What? How can it close? Oh, I see. Yes, we'll be right over.
What's up?
Anything Went is about to be gone. It may close.
How can they close a hit show?
Easy. Lauren Bacchanal is missing.
The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Tuesday, 4:46 p.m., and openings were happening all over NYC. The mayor cut the ribbon and reopened the refurbished Williamsburg Bridge, where he was heard to say, and, let me off of here. Jacques Cousteau was in town to open the part of the FDR Drive that's always underwater, where he was heard to say, glibba, glibba, glibba. And Betty Davis was in town to open Staten Island's newest landfill, where she was quoted as saying, what a dump. We were working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Frankly. The captain is Joe Greco. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. Things were slow at Mathnet HQ, or at least they were until an old college chum paid a visit. She was a dear friend who had gone into showbiz and was about to open in a musical comedy on Broadway called Anything Went. She dropped by the office to give me complimentary tickets to her opening. I should have realized there's no such thing as a free ticket. Watch, this is what happened.
Hi, Catherine.
Eve, this is my partner, George.
Frankly, Mathnet.
Eve and George had a lot in common. Eve is an actress and George is a fan. They talked about the business, one I know very little about.
This show is capitalized at $4 million.
$4 million?
Uh-huh.
Who invests money like that?
Angels.
We learned that the star of the show, a not-so-young actress named Lauren Bacchanal, had put up $2 million of her own money and then borrowed the rest, so to speak. The people who invested the other $2 million only got 15% of the show. That seemed like a big gamble, but then Eve explained.
The theater seats, 1,000. Let's assume it's a hit, and we sell out.
What's the average ticket price, Eve?
Approximately... $40. That means if we sell out the performance, we take in 40,000 dollars.
Just for one performance?
We give 8 performances each week. That's a possibility of 320,000. Dollars. Now that's gross, but the nut.
That means costs. Paying the actors, musicians, stagehands, renting the theater.
Uh-huh.
The nut is 60%.
Costs are... $192,000. That leaves... $128,000 a week profit.
That's more than I make.
You know how much you'd make if you sold out for a year? 52 weeks, $320,000 a week, $16,640,000.
Wow. Wouldn't take that long to make your $2 million back.
That's gross, though.
Right. Deduct a nut. The profit would be $6,656,000 a year. 15%. That is almost $1 million for the investors.
He was in the big leagues playing with big league dollars, that was for sure. The show opened, and at the opening night party, the reviewers all said Eve was wonderful.
Ooh, Clive loved it in the Post.
Frank liked it a lot in the Times.
Mustafa quelled in the Voice.
And it looked like Eve Adams was on her way to a good long run in the show. Then we got a phone call.
Yes, we'll be right over.
What's up?
Anything Went is about to be gone. It may close.
How can they close a hit show?
Easy. Lauren Bacchanal is missing.
George and I went to the theater and checked in with Pop Bespectacle, the stage door manager. Eve had left our names on a visitors list. She was on stage with the rest of the cast.
Please! As you know, we can't find our star. She may show up for the performance tonight, she may not. If she doesn't show, we have two options as I see it. We can close the show and give the people their money back.
What?
I know! I don't like it any better than you do! I'd like to remind you that people have laid mucho moolah on the line to see Miss Lauren Bacchanal.
Miss Fancy Britches.
The other option, as I see it, is to do the show with the understudy.
Oh, I'd much rather do the show with Eve in the lead any day, Joshua. What do you say, kids?
Yeah!
Well, since Miss Bacchanal is the producer and she isn't here, I guess we've just made her decision.
Yes! Thanks, everybody, but... to be fair, I think we should make an announcement before curtain, offering people their money back if they want it.
That's a good idea, Eve, and very generous. Okay, it's set. 1 hour for dinner, then everyone back here, and let's...
We're for living gifts! Yes.
We'll be counting on you.
Oh. Did you hear? I'm Miss Bacchanal's understudy,
uh-huh.
And I'm...
This could be your big break, Eve.
You're gonna knock him dead in the aisles, Eve.
Oh, thanks. Will you stay for the performance tonight?
Oh, sorry, Eve, but you've got to work.
Great, so. Time and tide and reports. Wait for no man.
But we'll be with you in spirit. You can count on that.
Thanks, Catherine.
We wanted to spend the night with Eve on the Great White Way, but it was not to be. We worked that night with our fingers crossed for our friend. And then the next morning there was lots of news. All good.
She did it, Pard. She did it.
In space. She's the toast of the town. Boy, I wish you could have seen her performance.
I have a feeling we'll be able to see a lot of her performances in the years ahead.
Did you see what the New York Times said about her? Eve Adams is the brightest talent to illuminate the Broadway sky in years.
Did you see Gene Shalit last night?
No, I watched Ted Koppel. What did he say?
He said, and I quote, Eve Adams should thank Lauren Bacchanal for not showing up last night, and so should theatergoers around the world. She is brilliant.
Wow, is that terrific or is that terrific?
Did you read what Variety had to say?
I did, but I didn't understand it.
Me either.
Well, they said... star, far, car, mar, flax, stacks, jacks, wax. I think that's good.
I called Eve to congratulate her, but just got her answering machine.
Well, I'm sure she was out celebrating last night into the wee small hours of the morning when the whole wide world is fast asleep.
I'm sure you're right. Mathnet Monday. Ah, believe it or not, we were just talking about you.
Congratulations. What? Really, when? We'll be right over.
Eve?
Eve. It's about Lauren Bacchanal. They know what happened to her.
They found her?
Nope.
You said they know what happened to her.
They do. She was kidnapped.
Coming, Catherine. George.
Sure thing, Eve. What happened?
Pop Bespectacled found a ransom note in Miss Bacchanal's dressing room.
When?
This morning.
Where is it?
The police have it.
Captain Greco, what are you doing here?
Oh, not much. Just trying to solve a crime. And you?
We're trying to do the same thing, I guess. May we see the note?
Are your hands clean?
If you want to see your star again, get $5 million. We will contact you shortly. Yours very truly, the kidnappers. Where'd you get this, Captain Greco?
I'll show you.
She got a send-off.
Must be well-wishers from opening night, I guess.
Here's one from Irving Berlin. Here's one from David Merrick. This one's from a former president.
What's it say?
I can't remember when I had a better time.
The note was found here.
Well, actually, it was about here.
Thanks, Pop. That's the kind of attention to detail that's going to keep you guarding stage doors for the rest of your natural life.
Thank you.
What I can't figure out is why the note was left here.
What do you mean, Catherine?
Catherine?
Catherine.
What I mean is, when you kidnap someone, you leave the ransom note at the spot of the kidnapping, don't you?
Well, I've never kidnapped anyone, but yes, I would say that is generally the case.
So she was kidnapped from here?
She couldn't have been kidnapped from here.
Why not?
Because she didn't show up last night.
Oh, yeah. Right.
So the kidnappers just figured someone would find it here. They just came in and left the note.
No way. No way they could come in here without me seeing them.
You got eagle eyes. Is that it, Pop?
I got eagle mirrors. Oh, come on. I'll show you. Here. Here, look. Anybody gets in or out of this theater without me seeing them.
Uh-huh. Yeah, but also, I see what you don't see.
What do you mean?
The stagehand just shoved one of those things.
Oh, those things are called flats, Sonny. It's part of the scenery.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, it obstructs your view.
Are you screaming at me, Mama?
Just a question.
It better not be hard.
Do you put this flat here every night?
Yeah, twice a night. You got a problem with that?
No. Twice a night?
Just before the first act curtain and once midway through act two.
Always at the same time?
That's right.
How long is it here?
20 minutes before the show and maybe 5 minutes during act two. Anything else?
No, thank you.
You're welcome.
So, someone could use this real exit door without you seeing it.
Captain Greco, when do you think the kidnappers will contact us?
I don't know when, and I don't know how or whom.
Who?
We'd better put a monitor on this telephone in case they try phoning.
It's a good idea.
You won't have to tie a man up, Captain. Just use Lauren's answering machine.
What are you doing here?
We're gonna have a party.
Is it a gun?
What does it look like?
And who are these two masked men?
We're all partygoers.
Shall we?
No, I won't go. Please, stop. You're hurting me. Don't shoot. Don't put that gag in my mouth. Please.
Happy birthday, everybody. Happy birthday to you.
Eve, what's this all about?
I have no idea.
Did you and Lauren have an argument, Eve?
Of course not. Why would we argue?
Why, indeed.
The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Wednesday, 2:43 p.m., and New York was awash with visiting celebrities. Princess Di was visiting from England. Princess Anne was visiting from Monaco. Princess Cinderella was visiting from Disneyland, and the Princess Cruise Line was sinking in New York Harbor. We were working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Frankly. The captain is Joe Greco. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. George and I found ourselves in a world we knew little about, the world of Broadway show business. A dear friend, Eve Adams, was in a Broadway show, or was she? We decided to look at scenes from earlier shows to get back on the train of thought. Eve had the second lead in a revival of a musical called Anything Went. She dropped by our office to give us two tickets to the opening night performance.
I'd love to talk more, but
You have to dash?
See you after the opening. Show!
Break a leg.
Knock him dead, kid.
I loved the show, and more importantly, so did the critics. Eve got rave reviews, although the star, Lauren Bacchanal, was, well, what they call in showbiz, panned. At an opening night party, she said,
Miss Bacchanal, the show's gonna make it.
Maybe yes, maybe no.
Oh, he loved you. You know how he's always kidding big stars.
Would you please remove yourselves from our path?
Miss Bacchanal, I wonder if I might trouble you for an autograph. It's for my mom. She used to take me to all your shows when I was a little boy.
Trouble, unfortunately, was just around the corner. Miss Bacchanal turned up missing for the next day's performance. But then Eve got a big break. She was Miss Bacchanal's understudy. Her substitute? She got to go on as the star of the show.
This could be your big break, Eve.
You're gonna knock him dead in the aisles, Eve.
And knock him dead she did. She was hailed as a new Broadway star. But then a note was found about the old Broadway star.
If you want to see your star again, get $5 million. We will contact you shortly. Yours very truly, the kidnappers.
Ms. Bacchanal had been kidnapped. Later we played the tape on her telephone answering service and were astounded to hear.
What are you doing here?
We're gonna have a party.
Is it a gun?
What does it look like?
And who are these two masked men? We're all partygoers. Shall we?
It went on and it seemed to implicate my friend.
Eve, what's this all about?
I have no idea.
Did you and Lauren have an argument, Eve?
Of course not. Why would we argue?
Why, indeed.
George, how are you?
Irate. That's how I am. Have you seen the morning papers, if that's what you call these rags?
No, but I heard the news on television.
Look at this headline. Broadway star kidnapped by Broadway starlet. And this one. Has been hijacked by would-be. And this one. Broadway biggie goes bye-bye.
They're being pretty rough on Eve.
And it's all circumstantial evidence, Kate.
I know.
We know that Eve did not kidnap Lauren Bacchanal. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless Eve did kidnap Lauren Bacchanal.
George, Eve has nothing to do with this kidnapping.
Don't be so sure, Kate. Or should I call you Catherine?
You should call me Kate, Jose.
What's up, Captain?
The kidnappers called and left this message on the answering machine in Lauren's dressing room.
Rats, we were just getting to the good part.
When did this come in?
47.5 minutes ago. I'm bringing Eve Adams in for more questioning.
We've got to think of something, some way to help Eve.
Kate, let me play devil's advocate.
What do you mean?
Let me sketch this scenario for you. Suppose, just suppose, Lauren showed up Tuesday night to do the show.
But we know she didn't.
No, we don't know that. Not for sure. So, let's assume she showed up.
No one saw her, George. Not even Pop bespectacled, and he sees everyone. Remember his mirrors?
Yes. But remember what the stagehand said. Pop's view. Is obstructed by this flat for about 20 minutes before the opening curtain.
So?
Again, just suppose Lauren showed up while the flat is blocking Pop's view and Eve is in Lauren's dressing room, lying in wait, so to speak.
Eve wouldn't do that.
Lauren shows up. Eve has hired two big bozos to grab her and take her outside, again, while the flat is blocking Pop's view.
That is ridiculous. Eve is not that kind of person.
Kate, you knew Eve years ago. People change. Stardom is a powerful lure. It has a magnetic force unto itself, independent of other forces. I read that in the Sunday Times once.
Hi, Kate.
Hi, Sergeant Abruzzi.
Here's a cassette.
I just heard it.
No, this is a different one. Bye, Kate.
Bye, Sergeant Abruzzi.
Couldn't have said it better myself. What kind of message is that? Play it again. Makes no sense.
George, remember another case we had a while ago in California?
I remember a lot of cases in California, Kate. Those were the good old days. The Dodgers, the Lakers, the Kings.
This case involved another kidnapping. Remember those two Looney Tunes from Michigan State who kidnapped Steve Stringbean, the rock star?
Oh, sure. He used the telephone and sang the tones to give us a clue as to where they were hiding him, of course.
Maybe this is something like that.
But no one is singing.
Something else. Play it back and let's see what numbers those tones correspond with.
Okay. Here's the first tone. Okay. The first one is a 2.
2.
The second is a 5.
Good going, Pard. Keep it up. Maybe Lauren was trying to tell us where she was being held, just like Steve Streambean did. It was a bit of a reach, but when you're trying to solve a problem and help a friend at the same time, you have to try absolutely every possibility.
Here it is, Kate.
Off the top, there doesn't seem to be any number pattern that repeats itself, does there?
No, there doesn't.
George, maybe it's a phone number.
Pretty big for a phone number.
For the area code first?
Well, maybe.
Let's try it.
Okay. Dial area code 253.
253?
254. 687369. We've got two numbers left over.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the number or call your operator for assistance.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll ask my operator for assistance. Hello, ma'am. Can you tell me where area code 253 is located? It isn't? There isn't a 253 area code in the entire country. I see. Thank you, ma'am.
NG, Kate?
No good. All area codes in the United States have either a 1 or a 0 in the middle.
There are no 1s or 0s in the entire sequence.
Maybe it's a different kind of code. What if each number stands for a letter of the alphabet? You know, like 1 is A, 2 is B.
Okay. First number is 2. The second letter of the alphabet is...
A B.
The second number is 5. A, B, C, D, E. E is the fifth letter.
B, E. Go on.
Oh, wait a minute, Kate. This isn't going to work. We've only got numbers 2 through 9.
So?
Well, that would limit our alphabet to the letters B through I. You can't make very many words with just those letters.
Maybe we should use single digits and double digits.
Yeah. But the only double digit that would work is 25. That would be Y.
Uh-huh. And there are no zeros or ones, so we can't have an A, for example.
And there are no letters corresponding to the teams. Maybe it isn't a code at all. Maybe it's just some kind of glitch in the phone system. You know, sometimes you're phone rings and there's no one on the other end.
Or maybe we just haven't figured out the code. Maybe she's trying to spell the message in another way.
You mean spell without letters?
Kind of like that. Using phone numbers.
Numbers? Yeah. Every number on the phone has three corresponding letters.
Except 0 or 1.
Well, that fits. They're not on the list. Let's try it. I'll make a chart.
What's this? Taking a night course in hieroglyphics?
No, Captain. Just trying to figure out what this case is all about. How's Eve?
Sticking to her story.
Do you believe her?
Her story? I'd like to, but no. She's got too much evidence against her. She's got no alibi.
But, Captain...
Look, she had motive, and she had the opportunity.
Oh, boy. It's a lot better now, Kate.
Really? You got something?
I'm kidding. Listen, Cleobus Poi.
Bless you.
Sounds like a linebacker from Penn State.
It's got to be a code. We just haven't broken it yet. What are you doing, Pard?
You know how many combinations there are on this chart, Kate?
I don't know. Millions? Billions? I haven't got my calculator.
Well, we can estimate. There are 12 columns with 3 letters in each column. That's 3 to the 12.
And since 3 times 3 is 9, multiplying 12 threes is the same as 6 nines. And 9 to the 6th is less than 10 to the 6th.
And we know that 10 to the 6th is 1 million.
So we're dealing with fewer combinations than 1 million. That's doable.
Have either of you Mathnetters seen this?
It does look familiar.
It sure does. It's the necklace that Lauren Bacchanal wears in all her shows. It's her good luck piece.
That's right. She's worn it in every performance for the past 40 years. She cherishes it.
Where did you get it?
Believe it or not, it was found by my men.
Really? Where?
In Eve Adams' dressing room a little while ago.
What are you going to do, Captain?
Nothing.
Not until this evening's performance is over. Then.
Yes?
I am going to have to arrest Eve Adams and put her where the sun don't shine.
In jail?
In jail.
The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Thursday, 9:43 a.m., and Carnegie Hall was alive with the sound of music. Flugelmeister was playing Krusevitsky, Scheistermeister was playing Rachmaninoff, and Lindel was playing Becker. The concert halls were filled, and in the Carnegie basement, a bunch of jazz cats were playing Tom and Jerry's Der Flatterter Mouse Der Better. There wasn't a sour note in the city. We were working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Frankly. The captain is Joe Greco. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. We found ourselves involved in a bizarre kidnapping involving a one-time Broadway star and a will-be Broadway star. The will-be was a friend named Eve Adams. We decided to eyeball a couple of scenes from earlier flickers to get our heads screwed on right. When the star of a just-opened musical called Anything Went turned up missing, Eve had to go on in her place.
This could be your big break, Eve.
You're gonna knock him dead in the aisles, Eve.
Oh, thanks. Will you stay for the performance tonight?
We had work to do, so we couldn't. But she didn't need our support. The show was a smash hit.
Did you see what the New York Times said about her? Eve Adams is the brightest talent to illuminate the Broadway sky in years.
I was one proud mathematician, but then they found out what really happened to the star, Lauren Bacchanal.
They found her?
Nope.
You said they know what happened to her.
They do. She was kidnapped.
Not only was she kidnapped, evidence pointed to Eve as a kidnapper.
We know that Eve did not kidnap Lauren Bacchanal. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless Eve did kidnap Lauren Bacchanal.
Of course, it was possible that Eve had something to do with it, but I just knew she couldn't have. Then we got a message from Miss Bacchanal on her answering service.
Must raise the ransom. I've already given them $2 million from the production, but you'll have to raise 3 more. They're holding me at...
Then we got a second tape recording. This one was just a series of 12 touch-tone telephone tones. We thought it might be a code. We matched the tones with the corresponding numbers on the telephone.
Here it is, Kate.
Off the top, there doesn't seem to be any number pattern that repeats itself, does there?
No, there doesn't.
If it was a code, it was a tough one to break.
Maybe it's a phone.
We tried to match the numbers on the phone with the letters each represented.
Oh, boy. It's a lot better now, Kate.
Really? You got something?
I'm kidding. Listen. Cliff Cleobusploy.
Bless you.
Sounds like a linebacker from Penn State.
Got to be a code. We just haven't broken it yet.
Then Captain Greco showed us another piece of evidence. A necklace that belonged to Miss Bacchanal.
Where did you get it?
Believe it or not, it was found by my men.
Really? Where?
In Eve Adams' dressing room a little while ago.
What are you gonna do, Captain?
Nothing. Not until this evening's performance is over. Then.
Yes?
I am going to have to arrest Eve Adams and put her where the sun don't shine.
In jail?
In jail.
Morning, George.
Hi.
How was your evening?
Okay.
What's the capital of Iowa?
About 9:57.
George, what the heck are you doing?
Remember that number letter code we got yesterday?
If that's what it was, yes. We couldn't make much sense out of it.
Well, not when we looked at the bottom line. Then I thought, maybe the second line.
And that made sense?
No, it didn't. Neither did the first line.
So you still haven't answered my question, George. What the heck are you doing?
Look.
What's this?
Look. I can slide these up and down. Yeah.
You like sliding cardboard strips up and down, do you, George?
Remember how we said there were an awful lot of different combinations
you can make here?
Uh-huh.
There are 531,441 different combinations.
So that's why you turn to a life of sliding cardboard strips up and down.
This is a combinatoric graphic. By moving these up and down, I can look for letter patterns which make words.
But 500,000 combinations.
But that's another thing. There really aren't 531,441 different combinations.
But 3 to the 12th is...
How many combinations can you make from these first two columns?
I can follow each of these three letters with any of these three letters.
Well, 3 times 3 is 9. But you really don't have 9 because... Look, there are no English words that begin with BK, BJ, CK, or CJ.
So right away we've eliminated 4 of the 9. That cuts the number of combinations almost in half.
Yep, so I started looking for words in this melange.
I see. Box. Hour. Hour.
Now, here. Ale. Ox. Jim. Here, I've made a list. The longest word I found is house.
Maybe she's being kept in a house.
Maybe. The trouble is, a lot of these words overlap. You know, use the same letters. Like hour. And house. Both words couldn't be in the same message.
Right. Try moving the strips again, from left to right.
Okay. We get ale, nothing beyond that. A-L-E-A, nope. A-L-E-B, nothing. A-L-E-C.
Nickname for Alexander?
Next letter is K. Alec House?
Maybe there's a place called Alec House. Go on.
Okay, with B, we get B-L-E-A-K. Bleak House?
Maybe. Try C.
Cleek House.
Okay, we've got 3 possibilities. What about the last 2 columns?
Okay. Alec House... Bleak House, Cleek House. O-Y, O-X, O-W, N-W, N-X, N-Y, M-Y, M-X, M-W. Not much.
George, wait. N-Y.
And why? New York, of course. Alec House, New York, or Bleak House, New York, or Cleek House, New York.
Maybe it's a hotel. I'll check with our computer people.
Morning, Kate.
Morning, Captain.
How'd the collar go last night, J. Edgar?
You think I like locking up pretty actresses? I had to do it, George.
I know, I know. She all right?
She's as comfortable as anyone can be in jail. She still says she's innocent.
Well, Kate and I think so too, Skipper. I'm trying to break this coded message we found yesterday. Could lead us to Miss Bacchanal.
Good luck.
A little good news, a little bad news. Which do you want first?
Oh, the bad news, I guess.
The bad news is there isn't an Alec House, a Bleak House, or a Cleek House in New York City.
Terrific. What's the good news?
There is a Bleak House in New York State.
Really? Where?
In a town called Nyack.
Nyack? N-Y-A-C-K?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's where she is. Why didn't she spell out Nyack?
Maybe she was cut off by the kidnappers.
Got the address?
Partner, let's roll. We called Benny, our undercover cop, substitute teacher, and driver extraordinaire, and along with Captain Greco, headed north to see what we could see. We had stuck with it, which is what you have to do to solve tough problems. Of course, we thought we had the answer, but you're never sure until it checks out. Bleak House looked as though it had seen better days. We called the local police for backup in case we ran into trouble with the kidnappers.
Question or two?
Go ahead.
Did you know the men who kidnapped you?
I never saw them. It was too dark in my dressing room, and they kept me blindfolded here, except at night. But then it was too dark to make out their countenances.
So you really can't identify them?
Perhaps by their voices. They were gruff.
Most kidnappers are.
Very gruff, Mr. Franklin. One of them broke my nail when he slammed the phone down while I was sending my code.
And it was a very clever code, too.
Thank you.
Were there just two men, Miss Bacchanal?
Isn't that enough? Two men and that treacherous, conniving little vixen who tried to take over my part.
Eve was here?
She was.
You said you were blindfolded.
I heard her. It was Wednesday afternoon. She came here to collect her share of the boodle, or whatever you policemen call that.
Money. We call it money.
If you can't finger those two mugs, I'm afraid you're out the $2 million ransom.
File it under the cost of doing business. And now, if you'll excuse me, my public awaits.
Come, George. Our office awaits. George and I decided to visit Eve to try and cheer her up. She was lower than a snake's hips.
It's nice to see friends, even under these circumstances.
We just wanted you to know. Well, I don't know.
We still like you, even if you're a crook.
George.
I mean, even though it looks like.
I understand. But I am not a crook.
Where have I heard that before?
Eve, how do you explain this? Lauren said she heard your voice in Nyack.
Nyack? I've never been to Nyack. I've never even heard of Nyack.
I hadn't either.
Lauren said she heard your voice there last Wednesday. Said she thought you'd come back to pick up your share of the ransom.
Well, if I did, where's the money?
Matter of fact, we've gotten a court order to check out your bank transactions, Eve.
Check away. All you'll find is about $800 in change.
I'm sorry we have to snoop, but we do.
That's okay. It would have been more. You know, the balance. Except for my first paycheck.
Oh, you finally got paid?
Uh-huh. And can you beat it? I took it to Lauren's bank and the check bounced.
Your first paycheck bounced?
Yep. Boy, when things go bad, they go bad.
Eve, you gotta go.
Thanks for showing me your line.
Keep your chin up, Eve.
Catherine.
Eve?
When was I supposed to have been in Nyack?
Last Wednesday afternoon.
Fancy that. An alibi.
What?
Last Wednesday afternoon. I was on stage doing a matinee performance of Anything Went. Remember?
The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Friday, 9:43 a.m., and it was awards time in New York City. Broadway was picking up its Tonys, Off-Broadway was getting its Obies, mystery writers were getting their Edgars, and ventriloquists were picking up their Charlies. We were working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Franklin. The captain is Joe Greco. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. We were locked in a real problem-solving crime that had taken us backstage along the great white way of Broadway show business. A dear friend, Eve Adams, needed our help. We were willing to give it, but first we needed to look at a few scenes edited for television to get us thinking right. Lauren Bacchanal was a Broadway star. The operative word is was. She had opened in a revival of a musical comedy called Anything Went, but then she disappeared and Eve Adams stepped in for her. To say that Eve was a hit would understate the reviews. She was a smash. But then we found out what actually happened to Lauren Bacchanal.
She was kidnapped.
Not only was she kidnapped, but the evidence pointed to Eve as the kidnapper.
I am going to have to arrest Eve Adams and put her where the sun don't shine.
In jail?
In jail.
And that's just what Captain Greco did, even though George and I were sure she hadn't done it. We had received a coded message from Miss Bacchanal, but we're having trouble breaking it. But we kept at it. You have to when trying to solve an important prob. George had arranged what he called...
This is a combinatoric graphic. By moving these up and down, I can look for letter patterns which make words.
And that's what we did, trying to make some sense of the telephoned message code we'd received. But there were 12 columns of letters. They can make an awful lot of words.
How many combinations can you make from these first two columns?
I can follow each of these three letters with any of these three letters.
Well, 3 times 3 is 9. But you really don't have 9 because, look, there are no English words that begin with BK, BJ, CK, or CJ.
Through the analysis of letter combinations, we came up with 3 possibilities and finally came up with a place called Bleak House. It turned out to be a hotel.
In a town called Nyack.
Nyack? N-Y-A-C-K?
Uh-huh.
That's where we figured she was, and that's where she was indeed. Logical thinking had triumphed again. We freed her.
I never thought I'd see freedom again.
And we were afraid of the same fate for Eve Adams, now convict Eve Adams, about whom Miss Bacchanal said...
A treacherous, conniving little vixen who tried to take over my part.
Eve was here?
She was.
You said you were blindfolded.
I heard her. It was Wednesday afternoon.
But when we visited Eve in jail, she said...
When was I supposed to have been in Nyack?
Last Wednesday afternoon.
Fancy that. An alibi.
What?
Last Wednesday afternoon. I was on stage doing a matinee performance of Anything Went. Remember?
Suppose you saw what the morning papers said.
Didn't get a chance to look at them. Ooh. We could keep a Boy Scout troop alive for weeks with this many old papers parred.
They all said Lauren is hammier than ever, but mainly because of us, the show may well run forever.
Because of us?
We found her and she found newfound fame.
You can't mete out justice to only the people you like, Kate.
I cannot help but notice, George, that you are tied to a chair.
That's right, Kate. I did it myself.
All by yourself? My, what a big boy.
This is a trick knot, Kate. It's the same kind we found around Lauren.
In other words, you could have tied herself to the chair?
Uh-huh. The only problem is...
I know. Why?
Right.
We could play What Do We Know?
Okay. Shoot.
We know Eve has an ironclad alibi. She couldn't have been on stage and in Nyack at the same time.
But Lauren was blindfolded, obviously scared. She could very easily have lost track of time.
And thought she heard Eve in the afternoon when it was really...
the morning.
Maybe. But I think we should check it out.
I've got a call into the Port Authority, Kate. I asked them to check on whether or not Eve could have gotten up to Nyack and back for a 2 o'clock curtain last Wednesday on a bus or a train.
Thanks, George. You believe her too, don't you?
I'd like to, but the facts still say otherwise.
Who had anything to gain from the kidnapping?
The kidnappers, Kate. That's usually the case.
Who else?
Eve. Obviously. She got her big break.
I know.
Mathnet, frankly. Oh, yes, thanks for returning my call. She couldn't have made it by train, but there was a bus that could have gotten her up there by 10 a.m. and one that could have gotten her back by 1:30 p.m. Rats. What? Oh. Thank you. Thank you very much.
She could have made it?
Yes. Except Wednesday.
The bus doesn't run on Wednesday?
It's supposed to run on Wednesday. But the dispatcher said... the one last Wednesday broke down in Closter, New Jersey.
So it never made it to Nyack that day.
Hello, New Jersey Transit. I'm looking for a bus.
While George telephoned the bus company, I reviewed a few of our facts. When working out a problem, it's often a good idea to sit back, take a deep breath, and cogitate. Perchance to solve.
The people on that bus were taken back to New York City, where they were put on the next bus to Nyack at 3 p.m.
Right in the middle of Eve's performance. She couldn't have been there, George.
Unless she rented a car.
She didn't.
How do you know?
She can't drive.
Lots of people in New York can't drive, but they do.
George, let's go have a chat with Lauren Bacchanal. We questioned Miss Bacchanal again, but she stuck to her story. Clung to it is more appropriate. Then she said...
I must leave now. So if you'll excuse me...
Excuse the interruption.
Lauren.
Yes, Joshua, yes. We must do business.
We have to deal with scads of unpaid bills. We could do lunch.
Fine, fine, fine. Let me put my recorder on first. Hi there. You've reached the star. She's going out to play in the heavens. Leave a message and I'll get back to you. Ciao. Shall we?
Did you notice something funny?
Like?
On some telephone answering machines, you can press the record button and leave your outgoing message, and it automatically recycles to the beginning of the tape.
Yes, mine's like that.
Uh-huh. Lauren's isn't. You have to keep your finger on the button.
So?
Let's go see our friend Eve.
Masked men. We're all partygoers.
Shall we?
No, I won't go. Please, stop. You're hurting me. Don't shoot. Don't put that gag in my mouth. Please, help me.
Happy birthday, everybody. Happy birthday to you.
Why have you played that again, George?
Yes, George. What are you up to?
How could Lauren Bacchanal have kept the record button depressed while all of that was going on?
You're right. She couldn't have.
We even heard the door slam. That couldn't have happened. The tape has to be phony.
But how did she get Eve to say those things?
You know something that just occurred to me.
What?
Everything I say on this tape is from the show.
It is?
Yes, but not in that order.
Maybe she tape recorded your performance.
She wouldn't have had to.
What do you mean?
During rehearsals, the whole show was taped just to help us learn our lines. Lauren would have had a copy of that tape. And she could have edited it.
I'll be gosh darned.
George, let's go talk to Captain Greco. Eve, things are starting to look up.
Thanks, guys.
We filled the captain in on our new facts. He was impressed, but not convinced of Eve's innocence.
You're still missing one thing, Mathnetters.
What?
Motive. Why would Lauren Bacchanal kidnap herself? What would she have to gain?
Good point. Unless she really thought she could collect the ransom.
But it wasn't paid.
Not all of it, but $2 million of it was.
Yes, but that was her money.
Maybe it was. Maybe it wasn't. George, let's go see if we have a friend at Chase Manhattan.
We got a court order which allowed us to investigate the bank records for the production of Anything Went. We found a couple of surprises.
Are you sure there isn't a second account for this production, Ms. Snood?
Do you mean if I made a mistake? Of course not. I am a vice president. Mistakes are not in my job description.
I see what you mean, George. The most money that was ever in the account was $2 million. Is that right?
Yes.
But the show was capitalized at $4 million. Remember? Lauren put in $2 million, and they raised another $2 million from the backers. Where is it?
Well, heaven knows I don't have it.
The other strange thing is, none of the money was spent. It just sat in the account.
Until the account was closed and all $2 million was taken out in one fell swoop.
And that was done?
Last Monday.
Last Monday?
Yes, Mr. Frankly. The day that comes between Sunday and Tuesday.
Kate, that woman is not only a hammy actress, she's a prophet.
She certainly is a prophet, George. She withdrew the money
before she was kidnapped.
Come on, George.
Let's roll.
We went back to Mathnet headquarters and laid out the story to Captain Greco. He agreed. We had a strong case. Later, we picked up Eve and Benny and started to the theater. On the way, we discussed the case.
But why did she fake her own kidnapping?
She wanted the show to close.
But why would she want the show to close?
If a Broadway show closes, all the investors lose the money they invested in it.
But...
No questions asked. She raised $2 million from backers, put up none of her own.
So if the show closed, she would keep whatever was left of the backers' $2 million.
And since she paid no bills...
It would all be there.
Most of it, anyway. She thought the show would be a bomb right from the beginning.
But Eve got such good reviews, it looked like the show might make it big.
Lauren couldn't take the chance of having a hit on her hands.
Steal the-
the bread and blame Eve instead.
You're out of your head.
Your cold beer was dead.
Now your face is red.
No tears for you will shed when you're under lock and key.
You stole the dough and caused this flapping.
You thought you could catch us napping.
It didn't work.
You know you're a jerk. You're a jerk. You're a jerk.
You framed poor Eve and made her look so bad.
Sent her to jail.
You craven cad.
My, how you waxed, ma'am.
We just want the facts, ma'am.
When money was owed, you sent us a code.
We broke it. It showed that you had been stowed in some old abode.
The seed had been sowed.
And so Eve was nearly history.
You cooked the books.
I think you've all gone crackers.
No, we've got proof.
You made a goof.
Cause we found out Eve had an alibi.
One that we had to rally by.
Don't you know? I did your show.
The phone tape
you made.
Ransom
unpaid.
My neck.
Mislaid,
kidnapping,
charade, the whole escapade
is starting into fade, my dear.
As you hold on to the bag, on Wednesday Eve was not in my act.
Instead she was doing my act, so I confess.
You're under arrest.
Lauren Bacchanal was tried in Manhattan in and for the city of New York and found guilty of a 155.42 grand larceny in the first degree and a 190.65 scheme to defraud in the first degree and a 13.13 letting the air out of an actor's ego. She was sent to prison where it was reported she was working on a new musical, working title, Time on My Hands.